Good evening. My name is Abby Harrell, and I play the violin. The next piece that we'll be playing for you tonight is called Allison's Waltz, written by Bob Phillips. Allison's Waltz is a fiddle waltz. In this piece, we worked on a lot using vibrato, which is an advanced technique which helps us create a rich and beautiful tone in our instruments. We hope you enjoy our rendition of Allison's Waltz.
Good evening, my name is Leila Garcia, and I play the violin. The last piece that Concert Orchestra will play for you tonight is called Lionheart by Benjamin Snowick. This piece was written to sound like a popular video game soundtrack. This piece is filled with intrigue and excitement. Every section in the orchestra, including our string bassist, gets to play the melody at one point or another. This is our favorite piece, and we hope that you appreciate it as much as we do.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Evelyn Frost, and I play the viola. The first piece that Chamber Orchestra will play for you tonight is titled North Star to Freedom by Soon-Hee Newbold. This piece was composed in honor of the Underground Railroad. Slaves in the South followed the North Star to various safe houses and stops on the way to the North for their freedom. Many would journey as far as Canada, where they were safe from being forced back into the South. Traditional songs such as Swing Low, Sweet Chariot were actually code and instructions for fleeing slaves. Ohio was a crucial and pinnacle point of the Underground Railroad because many people used the Ohio River to cross into safety. The journeys were very dangerous due to extreme weather, long and treacherous paths between stops, inadequate food and clothing, in addition to spies and bounty hunters who were paid to return slaves back to the South. The beginning of this piece is written in a somber and nostalgic manner. The theme in the bass and cellos is reminiscent of traditional spirituals sung by slaves working in the field. This is a beautiful piece that commemorates the long and dangerous journey that many undertook for a chance at freedom. We hope you enjoy our rendition of North Star to Freedom. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Kate Matsuda, and I play the violin. The next piece that we will play for you tonight is a beautiful piece called Adra's Dance. Adra's Dance was composed as a beautiful homage to the whimsical nature of childhood. The composer composed this song to depict and describe the imaginary characters that his three-year-old daughter would create and tell him about. A favorite character was named Adra, who went on adventures with her father and loved to dance with her father in celebration when an adventure ended. This piece was written in dedication to his daughter. We hope that you enjoy this beautiful and whimsical piece, Adra's Dance.
The last piece that we will be playing for you tonight is appropriately titled Ignite. In this piece, we worked on concepts such as syncopation. Syncopation is when notes are played on the off beats instead of on the strong beats. In this piece, this rhythmical technique creates a sense of momentum and urgency as a listener. This is a tricky but exciting piece to play. We hope you enjoy our rendition of Ignite. Thank you.
Thank you. We're going to have a little set change as Strolling gets ready. And as Strolling gets ready, I have Mrs. Stephanie Williams. She is our Parent Booster President, and she's going to talk to you about some upcoming fundraisers, some Parent Booster needs, and so forth. So thank you, Ms. Williams.
Why, thank you. I'd like to say that my name is Stephanie Williams. I do not play an instrument like these wonderful musicians up here. But I am the current president of the Campo Verde High School Orchestra Boosters. Orchestra Boosters supports all students in the orchestra program through various financial needs and activities. So far this school year, the Boosters have contributed to the rental of instruments, including a harp that we'll hear later on tonight, piano tuning, straps for the cellos, and Monday's guest conductor, Mr. Murphy. Boosters have also supported the students during their lock-in activity in August, sizing and distribution of the uniforms, website design, social media posts, and scheduling fundraising activities. Tonight, we will begin the launch of the Butter Braids fundraiser. Sales of this delicious item will go through October 12th. Additional fundraisers are planned in the near future, including a car wash on October 16th, so kids get ready to scrub some cars down, and a Chipotle restaurant night on November 10th. Be sure to save the date for February 12th when dinner and music are provided by our talented orchestra students for a Valentine's-themed evening. If you're a parent of a student in orchestra, you are already a member of Orchestra Boosters. Our next meeting is October 12th at 7 p.m. in the orchestra classroom. All parents are invited to attend and contribute during the meetings. If you have a knack for decorating and planning, we are in dire need of your help. The decoration and event planning chair position for Orchestra Boosters is open. The position requires attendance at monthly meetings and decorating for various orchestra activities. Please let myself or Mrs. Payne know if you're interested. And at the conclusion of tonight's performance, we welcome all the audience members to join us for a reception of goodies, sampling of the butter braids, and celebration of the students and Mrs. Payne's dedication and hard work. Thank you all and have a great evening.
Good evening. My name is Steven Schmitz, and I play the cello. The first piece that we will be playing for you tonight is called Argent Edge by Doug Spada. This piece uses an advanced bow technique called ricochet. Ricochet is when our bow bounces multiple times in the upper half, and when played together, it creates a really intriguing sound. This piece also features Mason Thompson and Trevi Thompson on harp. We love playing this piece and hope that you love it as much as we do.
Brian Balmages. This piece was written and dedicated to his two children, He composed this piece after watching his two boys fall asleep. After watching them curled up and sleeping soundly, he imagined that they were what they were dreaming about. They seemed so content and tranquil, and he strived to depict that sense in this piece. We hope that you enjoy our rendition of this beautiful piece.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is AJ Ritz, and I play the viola. Sorry. The final piece that we will play for you tonight is the overture of the Russian opera Ruslan and Ludmila, written by the Russian composer Mikhail Glinka. It tells the story of the abduction of Ludmila, the daughter of Prince Vladimir of the Kievan Rus, who reigned 980 to 1015, by an evil wizard and the attempt by the brave knight Ruslan to find and rescue her. We worked very hard on this challenging piece, and we hope that you enjoy our rendition of Ruslan and Ludmila as much as we enjoy playing. Thank you for joining us tonight and for supporting Campo Verde Orchestras.
Thank you.
so much for coming tonight and for your enthusiastic support. All the groups did so well. Can we just do one more round of applause for everybody? I really enjoy, and I just don't say this, I really enjoy every single one of these students, from concert all the way to symphonic and strolling strings and chamber. It's such a joy to teach them, and I'm so excited to create music with them. And they know I work them hard, right? And I'm always pushing, but they're always eating it up because they really want to sound good, and they've all really improved this quarter. So I'm just super proud of them and can't wait to see how they further improve this school year. Thank you so much, parents, for supporting them, listening to them practice, encouraging them to practice, you know, buying strings, renting those instruments. It's very much appreciated. And thank you to administration. We have a fabulous administration here in Gilbert that supports our arts and our music. And I don't know if Dr. Janitis, I think he's here. There you are, all the way in the back. Thank you, Dr. Janitis, for all your support. We're very lucky. And I just want to say thank you to Aaron in the booth, who does all of our lights and our sound and our backstage and all of the student help. And thank you to my boosters. And we have some really fun activities. We want to take Concert Chamber to the Musical Instrument Museum in January. As you know, Chamber and Symphonic are doing a competition tomorrow, and Concert is doing a competition after break. We are also planning a California trip in February, and you'll get more details when that's board approved. And we also might do a Phoenix Symphony trip for the top ensemble. So we really want to get these kids out and playing and seeing things and get them, you know, doing things that they weren't able to do the last couple years. But that does take a lot of parent support and parent volunteers. So when I send out things, if you can be so kind to volunteer, to chaperone, or help with something, it is hugely appreciated. Even if your kid says, I don't want you on the trip, they're going to thank you later, I promise. Okay? You don't have to sit by them. But I know some students are like, no, I don't want to ask my mom. I don't want them to be a chaperone on the trip, or dad, or anyone. And then I just want to say, lastly, please do go to the reception in the cafeteria. It's meant for the students to celebrate all of their hard work and their success. So please do that, and otherwise have a wonderful night. Thank you.